one of the standards of high quality research, as stated by RANDS Corporation, include that the study should demonstrate understanding of related studies. Now, when we say it should demonstrate understanding of related studies, means the research which is being undertaken should contribute to the existing body of research, and there should be a relationship between what has already been done and what is being undertaken, and it should also evident that the work which has been carried out earlier has been taken into consideration, and it should also help the researcher to select the design for study and also explain the way in which the results of the present study are in agreement or disagreement with the studies which have already been taken. Thus, review of related literature forms an integral part of research, and in this program we are going to answer two important questions. That is, what is review of literature? What do we understand by that? And why is it essential to carry out review of related literature? Review of related literature has been defined as a systematic, explicit, and reproducible method of identification, evaluation, and synthesis of the work related to the topic or area of research already produced by practitioners, academicians, and researchers. Now, here it is very important to understand, when we say systematic, it follows certain orderly steps. Explicit, it is very clear and it can be reproduced. And identification here means that the researcher needs to locate the sources of information which contain the previous studies. And evaluation refers to whether the research which has already been published, is it relevant to the research which is being undertaken? Is it that the sample selected represent the population and the findings are journalizable? Is it that the context of the research, that is previous research, is relevant to the context in which the present study is being undertaken? And then the researcher is to synthesize the information abstracted from the various sources of information. Synthesis means collating the information gathered from the previous studies. Thus, the process of research is a systematic process, and it serves very important purposes for the researcher who is going to undertake a study. The very first purpose served by review of related literature is it facilitates selection and definition of the research problem. Review of related literature is carried out by the researcher initially to identify what has already been done and where are the gaps and what additional research study needs to be undertaken to bridge that gap. It helps the researcher to identify the variables which can be included in the study and also help him to state the objectives of research. Thus, it helps the researcher to build the rationale for the study, and you can justify undertaking research in that particular area. In addition to that, review of related literature helps the researcher in formulating the hypothesis for the study. Now, the previous work which is studied, if the findings are conclusive, it gives direction to the researcher to formulate directional hypothesis. If the findings of the study are inconclusive, it gives direction to the researcher to formulate either non-directional or to form null hypothesis. It also helps the researcher in establishing relationships or cause and effect relationships. The methodology which is used to carry out research can be refined or can be selected on the basis of the previous work. So, previous work will provide a basis for selecting appropriate methodology for conducting the research. So, whether the research we should use survey research or a case study would be a better approach, or a quantitative research or qualitative research can be undertaken, that becomes evident when the previous studies are taken into consideration. The technique for selecting a sample that can also be finalized on the basis of the previous work which has been carried out. Now, the previous studies can throw light what kind of sample has already been studied. If it has been extensively studied, maybe you would like to change your sample and carry out the study. Or if the population has been heterogeneous and the previous researcher has not taken that heterogeneity in the population into consideration, maybe this provides direction to the researcher that you need to select stratified random sample to justify the findings and generalize the findings on the population. So whether the population needs to be considered and what kind of sampling technique, whether probability sampling techniques are to be used or non-probability sampling techniques are to be used, that decision can be taken on the basis of review of related literature. Once you have finalized the sample, in addition to that, the tools which are going to be used, they can be decided on the basis of the previous work. So what are the tools which have been used by previous researcher to gather data for the variables included in the study? Whether a standardized test has been used and which standardized test has been preferred by the researcher, and whether that test is valid for the context in which the present study is being undertaken, or the researcher has tried to design and develop his own questionnaires, interview schedules or observation schedules. So it gives fairly good idea to the researcher to crystallize on the tools which will be used to measure the variables included in the study. Once the data has been collected, the previous work provides you direction with respect to the kind of analysis which can be carried out. So, depending upon the objectives and hypotheses which were formulated for the previous work, the statistical techniques have been used. So, the researcher can decide whether the technique for analyzing the data has been appropriate or what were the limitations of that technique. Those can be taken into consideration while finalizing the descriptive analysis which you would like to carry out or the inferential statistics you would like to employ on the data. Once the results are available to the researcher, the interpretation of that results get facilitated by the previous work, because the explanation built by the previous researcher can provide you insight how to interpret the findings of the present study, and then you can justify the findings of your study by relating or building association with the previous work. So whether the findings are in agreement with the previous studies or are in disagreement with the previous studies, and then the previous work can help you in providing plausible reasons or probable reasons to explain the results which have been obtained in the present study. In other words, we can say that review of related literature, once carried out, helps the researcher at different stages of research in selecting and defining the research problem, in finalizing the methodology to be used for carrying out the study, in analyzing the data, interpreting the data and the results obtained, and also to justify the findings of the present study.